Hi there. Are you having a problem that every time you delete the last page within a pleading document, your line numbers disappear? Let me help. Hey, I'm Sharyn from Excel at Work, where we offer straightforward, non-technical assistance to help you save time and work smarter within Microsoft Office documents. Right, let's have a look at how we can fix this document. And if you are wanting to learn how to delete those line numbers without actually having to delete the last page, check out my links to my other videos at the end of this video. Right, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to actually go to the bottom of this document and talk you through some steps. Now, this is just one of two documents I want to show you because there could be a couple of things going on within the document that could be causing this problem. So I'll just whip down to the bottom of this document. I'm just using Control End. And you'll see that I am now in section 2 of this document. So down the very bottom here, down here you can see section 2. Now, if I just come up a little bit and click at the top here, you will see that this is section 1. And of course you can see the section break. Now, if you can't see that section break, I would suggest that on the Home tab, you come and pop on your Show Hide Characters. If you can't see that, then you can't see your section break. Now, here's the problem. We've got this kind of extra page at the end of this document that we don't need. And of course, if we come up here and we delete the section break, it also removes those line numbers, which isn't helpful at all within a pleading document. So I'm just going to undo that and I'll talk you through what's going on. So I'll whip down to section 2 again. So we're on that last page, that extra page that we don't need. And I'm going to just double click up into this area at the top here. We're going into the header area of the document. Now, the line numbers actually live within a pleading template. They live on the left-hand side of the header. So I'm just going to come up to the previous header. We're at the moment, we're in the header for section 2. I'm going to make my way up to the previous section. So we're in the header and footer tab. I'm going to click onto previous and we'll move up into the previous section where you can see we have line numbers. But as you saw, if I go next down here, no line numbers, okay? So within a document, of course, if you've got section breaks, you can have different formatting settings within each section break, and that's what we've got here. Now, what I want to do, well, actually, I'll just talk you through what happens. This doesn't have the line numbering, so I'm just going to come out of here, make my way up, and remove that section break again. Now, unfortunately, what happens as soon as you delete the section break, the section break that was section number 2 becomes section number 1. And of course, we don't actually have any line numbers within section number 1. So of course, Word just goes, okay, well, I'll just mimic what was in section 2, make it section 1, and the line numbers disappear. And that's what's happening here. Horrible. Okay, I'll just undo and make my way back down to section 2 because that's where it's all happening. So I'm going to go back into headers and footers, just double click into the header area here and we'll get back into that header footer tab. If you're used to going to the insert tab and going to header from here and then edit, same thing. You can do exactly the same thing. So here we are in this section. Now I'm going to talk you through the juicy bit, the bit that you need to do to make sure that you don't lose your line numbers. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to do this, link to previous. When I click onto that, Word will actually say, do you want to delete this header? Yes. And connect it to the previous header? Yes. So I'm going to click onto yes. And look, we've got some line numbers. I'll talk about what's going on there in a minute. But what we're wanting to do, or what we have done, is we've actually copied the header from the previous section into this section. Now, what's going on with this is, and it's just in this document, it might not be the problem in your document. In this document, the margins are actually different in each section. So what I did was I went to the previous section and I went into the layout tab, margins, custom margins, and I could see within the custom margin setting the correct margin. So you can see, like, oh, I'm sorry, I'm in centimeters, I'm in New Zealand, -2.54 here. So if I just come out of here and then I'm just going to go back to header and footer and make my way back to section 2. Now again, I'll just go to the layout tab, margins, custom margins. Look, they're different. So I've written them down. I'm going to change them so that both sections are exactly the same. So I'm just going to come in here. So we're -2.54 there. And then we've got 3.56, 2.9, and 2.54 there. Okay, clicking on OK, and you'll see, look at this. All of a sudden, you can see your 28 lines, which is fantastic. So, sorry, 26 in this one, not 28, 26 lines. So what we're going to do is we're going to now whip down, let's go to the header and footer, make our way down to the footer area. And when we get down into here, you'll see that that doesn't match either. So if I go to previous, you're going to see that's what I'm wanting to bring down into the footer area. So I'll go next, and then I'm going to go link to previous. Yes, I do want to copy what was in the previous section into this section. And look, we're good to go. Okay. Now what I want you to do is I want you to unlink, because of course the two are actually connected. If I change anything in here, it will go up into the previous section. So I don't want the two to be connected. I'm going to actually unlink there and unlink in here as well. So I've unlinked between the footer and the header. Right, going to close out of here now. And of course that's what we're wanting in our section one. With our numbering. So look at this. If I come in here now and I press my delete key to take that the section break out, look, we're all good to go. No problems at all. So those two sections being quite different, and of course it's the section break that's actually creating that last unwanted page. Of course it is a bit yucky in the fact that when you delete it, you do need to do a couple of steps before the deletion. So that's option number one. I'm hoping that this has kind of helped you, but if it hasn't, let's look at option number two. So I'll just flip over to another pleading document. Right, same thing. I'm just going to whip to the end because we've got that spare page at the end, or the unwanted page at the end. This one's actually got the numbering on it. So if I come up here and go, well, okay, well, I don't want that. I just want to get rid of that section again. It's kind of like, well, hang on a minute. I could see that it was actually in that section. I've deleted the section break. Why haven't I got my line numbers? So I'll just undo that and let's go and have a look, because this has got one extra bit to it that's a little bit fiddly. So I'm going to come down to the extra page again. You'll see that if I click onto this extra page, I'm on section two. And up here, prior to the section break, of course, I'm on section one. So I'll come back into here. Again, I'm just going to do that double click. You could go insert, header, edit if you wanted to. And we're now into that header area. There's the link to previous. So if you wanted to take that off, you definitely can just get rid of it there. But here's the kicker. This is the thing that's different. This little button here has got different first page on it. And that's what the problem is. Because what's happening is within this section, it's almost like you've got two sections within a section. You can have a different first page for that section. And because it's actually saying it's got a different first page, possibly what's happening is when we're actually deleting that section break, within the different first page, there are no numbers. And that's what's happening. It's getting sucked up into section one. So I'm going to actually remove this little marker here. And let's just check. I'll just take that off now because it's now different. We were working with the different first page. Now we're just working with a normal section. So I'm taking that off. Let's go to the footer and make sure that's okay. So at the bottom here, we can actually go link to previous. I think it actually looks okay. Just the numbering's a little bit different, but I think that will be fine when we actually sort it out. So let's come out of here now, go close header. And let's just make our way up to here and delete our section break. And how are we looking? There you go. So we've got rid of that extra page at the end. We've kept our line numbers and our page numbering's fine as well. So I'm hoping one of these two options has helped you get rid of that extra page and keep your line numbers. Yay. Let me know in the comments below which one helped you. And if this has been helpful, please give it a like. And if you think it would be helpful to subscribe, I'd love that too. Okay, thanks for watching and have a fabulous day.